Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org. Do you use Java 8's Date and Time API in your project? Let's be honest, working with the Java util date is a pain, and I would like to replace it with a new API in all of my projects. The only problem is that JP8 does not support it. Java 8 was released after JP8 2.1, and the persistence standard does not support the new APIs. You can, of course, use LocalDate or other classes of the Date and Time API as entity attributes, but you can't annotate them with temporal, and Hibernate stores them as blobs in the database. You have two options if you want to use the correct JDBC types when you persist these classes. You can implement a JPA attribute converter, as I showed you in one of the previous videos, or you can use the Hibernate-specific Java 8 support, which was introduced with Hibernate 5. This approach is not portable to other JPA implementations, but much easier to use, as I will show you in this video. Hibernate 5 introduced the support for different Java 8 classes and shipped it in a separate jar file in version 5.0. You needed to add this file to the class path for your application if you wanted to use the new data types. Since version 5.1, this is no longer necessary. The Java 8 support has become part of the Hibernate core distribution. Hibernate supports the classes of the Date and Time API as basic types, so that you don't need to provide any additional mapping annotations. It gets all required information from the entity attribute type and maps them to the JDBC types you can see here on the slide. Okay, enough theory. Let's have a look at an example. Here you can see a simple entity with attributes of type LocalDate, LocalDateTime, and Duration. All three of them were introduced with the new Date and Time API in Java 8. As you can see, I didn't apply any additional annotations to define the mapping to the database columns. Hibernate already has all the information it needs. As you can see in this test case, you can use these attributes in the same way as any other attributes. I instantiate a new entity, call the setter methods to initialize the attributes, and persist the entity. And down here, I use the LocalDate attribute with a bind parameter in the WHERE clause of a JPQL query. Let's run this test and check how Hibernate handles the attributes of the Date and Time API. The test case was successful. Hibernate mapped the Java types to the correct JDBC types without any additional mapping annotations. It mapped the local date to a JDBC date, the local date time to a timestamp, and the duration to a big int. And when I executed the query with the bind parameter of type local date, Hibernate mapped the bind parameter value in the same way. Okay. That's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate 5. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below.